When a basketball team plays an out-of-conference schedule that includes Duke, North Carolina, and UCLA, it's safe to say they are battle-tested. When that same team then compiles a 17-0 conference record and a 15-game winning streak, it is also safe to say that those tough losses to the likes of Duke, North Carolina, and UCLA have taught you something. That team is Davidson this year, and for more on the Wildcats, we're joined by their head coach, Bob McKillop. Bob, a 15-game winning streak, why do you think you've been able to maintain that run?
Well, clearly what you referenced, the early schedule that we had, toughened us up, it hardened us. And of course, we also have a team that went through the same thing last year. We won 29 games last year, so we have been battle-tested, and it's not just been one season, but it's been over a duration of two seasons.
When you talk about battle-tested and those tough losses early on, what do you learn from them? What is a club able to take into the future with those?
Dana, interesting enough, we actually had a scrimmage to begin the season, and that was against the University of Texas. So we were down in Austin, so we got a great exposure as to what we needed to work on. Prepped us for Carolina, for Duke, for Charlotte, for NC State, for UCLA. It forced us how to handle the ball, to be tough with the ball, to be and still be aggressive in our system. Got us to understand both sides of the court are equally as valuable.
How successful do you think you've been in doing those things?
Well, clearly we've gotten better with our inside-outside game, having to go against a guy like Kevin Love and Tyler Hansbrough and the assortment of big guys that Texas had just made our big guys realize what they had to do to get better, to get positioned in the paint, to get stronger in the weight room. And that has clearly helped our perimeter game. And, of course, our perimeter game is highlighted by a terrific backcourt with Jason Bridges and Steph Curry.
How much consideration do you give to those early games, too, against high-caliber teams when it comes to thinking about Selection Sunday and if you needed an at-large bid?
You know, it's interesting that we played Carolina. It was our first game, I believe their first game as well. Bobby Fraser was still healthy 100%. Ty Lawson was healthy 100%. So we played Carolina at their best and played to a four-point game. I think that's a pretty good indication about the kind of talent we have and the kind of success that we're capable of achieving. And, of course, going through the conference play at this point with 17 victories indicates that we really profited from that experience.
You mentioned talent that you have. Stephen Curry, the son of former NBA guard Del Curry. What does he bring to this team?
Well, he brings talent, but he also brings an attitude that you don't see in too many of today's contemporary spoiled athletes. There's no entitlement whatsoever. He comes to the gym every day to work to get better. He doesn't think he's entitled to anything. And with that approach and with that attitude, you can see him getting better and better. He had a wonderful freshman year, and he's just getting better and better as he moves through his sophomore year.
How much do you think that has to do with the fact that he's got big shoes to fill? No pun intended when you talk about filling the shoes of an NBA player.
Well, I don't know so much as the big shoes that he has to fill as the great example that both his mom and dad have set for him and the way they have raised him. They've taught him, as parents should teach their children, how to handle responsibility and how to be accountable and how to work hard. And, of course, genetically, boy, you can't talk the kind of shooter that Del Curry was.
Now, here we like to find little different things, and we found this out about you. Fox News commentator Bill O'Reilly was a fellow student in your homeroom high school.
Yeah, for 4 years, every morning I went to homeroom, and it's an all-boys Catholic high school, and there was Bill O'Reilly three rows away. And I think anyone that went to Chaminade knew Bill O'Reilly because of the character that he was. And I think the apple hasn't fallen far from the tree in terms of what he was as a high school student to what he is now.
I was going to say, did you sort of get a preview of the show that he does right now?
Oh, clearly we did.
Bob, well, we appreciate you joining us. Good luck the rest of the season, and thanks for filling us in on O'Reilly as well.
Thanks, Dana.
The Davidson Wildcats, by the way, host UNC Greensboro tonight, 7 o'clock Eastern Time, and you can catch that game right here on ESPN2. Still to come here.